WASI 2024, Paper 2, written by students from Nigeria. Before we start solving, kindly share this video for me. Thank you, thank you, thank you very much. Now let's solve. A car starts from rest and accelerates at 1 meter per second squared for 10 seconds. It then continues at a uniform speed for another 20 seconds and decelerates to rest in 5 seconds. Find the total distance traveled. Find the distance traveled. The distance traveled is the area under the distance time graph, the velocity time graph. The area is the area of a trapezium, the trapezium you are seeing over here. So we need to find the parallel sides and add them. We know area of a trapezium is going to give us the distance, which is 1 over 2 times height, vertical height, times sum of the bases. Alright, so how do we get a height? We can get a height from this first phase of the journey. It took 10 seconds in the first phase. So t is equal to 10 here. Acceleration was 1 meter per second squared. Initial velocity was 0 meters per second. Final velocity, we don't know. We can use the equation of linear motion, v equal u plus at, to find the final velocity v. So v will be equal to 0 u plus at 1 times 10. V equal 10 meters per second. So the final velocity here is 10 meters per second. So velocity time graph. So it tells us that the height of the trapezium is 10. We're also told that we're also given the time that the travel was uniform speed. That was for 20 seconds. So this will be 20 seconds here. Then from there, it traveled for 5 seconds. So from this distance to this distance, that will be 10 plus 20 plus 5, which is 35 seconds. So S will be equal to 1 over 2 times 10, which is the height, times 35 time plus from this distance to this distance is 20 plus 20 seconds. So this will be equal to 5 times 55, which is 275 meters. That is the A part of the question. The average speed is given by total distance traveled over total time taken. So average speed, so B part, average speed is total distance over total time taken. Total distance was 275 meters over total time 35 seconds. And that will give us 7.86 meters per second. We now have to calculate the time taken to cover half of the distance. So the total distance was 875, half of the distance will be equal to 275 over 2, and that is equal to 137.5 meters. So we saw that we saw that 10 seconds was taken in the first phase of the journey. Now let's say that the additional time that is needed, t, for it to get to the half of the distance, 135.5 meters, 137.5 meters, is t. Then we know also that the height of the trapezium was 10. So the area of this half distance will also give us this over here. So this is a trapezium. What you are seeing here is another trapezium. Another trapezium. So you find the area of this trapezium. This will be t. This will be 10 seconds, and this will be t seconds. So we are going to form an equation. So the c area of trapezium is given by half, which is 137.5 meters, is equal to 1 over 2 times the height of the trapezium, which is 10, into the sum of the bases t plus t plus 10. So we have to solve this equation for t. Then we add it to 10 seconds to find the time taking to cover half the distance. So let's solve this. We are going to get 137.5 is equal to 5 into 2t plus 10. So 10t will be 10t plus 50 will be equal to 137.5. So 137.5 minus 50, which is 87.5, will be equal to 10t. Dividing through by 10, you get t to be 8.75 seconds. So the time taken to cover half the journey is 10 plus t, which is 18.75 seconds. So the time taken to cover half of the journey is t plus 10, which is equal to 18.75 seconds. So that is the C part. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Please don't forget to share this video.